Good morning, traders. Welcome to the new week. What is the day? The 19th in Asia, 19th of March. Got quite a lot of event risk coming up this week. Events that we think are actually tradable. We have a new PBOC governor. We've got three central bank decisions, which is the FOMC, the RBNZ, and the Bank of England come out this week. We also have some more. We have an EU and Brexit seminar, which could be interesting. Some data coming out of Canada later in the week. Wilkins is also speaking. And what else? Oh, yeah, the Germans at EW. So it looks like, you know, most event risk really starts Wednesday. It's kind of Wednesday and Thursday are the big days. Let's take a look at some of the commodity currencies. Here's a weekly. I'm just going to check out the weeklies. I'm sorry we're getting this to you so late. It's a little later than normal on the Monday morning. Let's take a look at some of the weeklies. Australian dollar weekly, big bearish engulfing, took out 2 weeks of lows, closed right in the lows, and you know we're hanging around here, just around 77 cents. If we look at the daily, you know, this looks like it's kind of breaking down. We got to get rid of some of these old Fibos. You know, this is a big swing though here that will be. We think the market's following from these old lows back here in December. And we had that parabolic rise at the beginning of the year. It looks like we want to go and retrace three quarters of this move, which is down at 76.60. And under there, then I don't see why we can't get back down to these levels that we saw in December. Here's New Zealand dollar. A couple of really big down days. We're through the short-term fibs. We can get rid of those now. And, you know, we are approaching this low here, 71.80. We've got the confluence with the 200-day down here at 71.85. We also have an old low here. So this area here is just massive. You know, we call this the double top in Kiwi. And, you know, the vol has picked up. The front-end vol has really picked up. And the event risk is immigration, the RBNZ this week, and the milk auctions, as well as deteriorating terms of trade. Some people might want to call this kind of a head and shoulders, which I'd rather call it a double top. But if we start getting under this 200-day and these old lows, we're going to do a big retrace. So let's get the fibs out here for the the November low up to the double top up here. You know, we haven't even retraced. The interesting talk about confluence. We've got 71.86, the old low. 76, that low, 200.84. So this area in here, if we start closing the day under here, you know we're gonna retrace more of this, get under the 100-day, and you know we see no reason why we can't even get down to this kind of low 70 handle. Just remember, I mean, these commodity currencies have had massive runs, and if you pop over to the actually, let me just look at the weekly. Weekly Kiwi. Weekly Kiwi was a reversal week, not quite. Couldn't quite get below the previous week's lows, but it, you know, it is a bearish engulfing type pattern. However, not off the highs. So here it is. If you look at the weekly, we actually have a triple top. We like this. We like being short Kiwi this week. There's enough potential for negative event risk to come out. Canadian dollar, also yet another weak commodity currency. We're getting up to this 131.30, which is a short fib swing. Very, very big up bar on the weekly. So I think, you know, playing the short side of the commodity currencies look pretty good. Let's take a look at some of the stocks. What did the stocks do last week? S&P's, reversal lower week. This is actually last week's bar right here where I'm pointing. After four red bars, four to five red bars, or yeah, four out of the five bars last week were red bars. So again, you know, the hint of risk off. NASDAQ has been performing better, but again, here's the daily. Four down days, reversal week. We'll see how things play out in early part of this week. Positioning. I was reading that the positioning in sterling, for a weaker sterling, has pretty much disappeared. Where the on the option side and even on the CFTC and all the other positioning indicators, where sterling positioning has now it's fairly neutral. So I think that's got room to make a move one way or the other. Positioning is really no longer a impediment to the next direction. So again, let's take a look. You'll hear from us on the European Open. You know, not much out as far on the economic calendar here in the next 12 hours, but we do think it's an interesting week. Most of it really being on toward the latter part of the week with the European Council Brexit, UK Brexit meeting, and then next, you know, in the next couple of weeks, we've got everything from more NAFTA talks, round number 8, if you can believe it, in NAFTA. We got the Japanese, the Moritomo scandal still kind of going on with Abe. Abe and ASO. So there's, that's just a headline game, and we think there'll be some tradable headlines in the next week or two. That should do it. You will hear from us on the London, on the European Open. And good luck trading this session. So far, it looks pretty quiet. And we will speak to you in a few hours. All right, good luck. Cheers. Bye.